Previously, we met with Ken at Bulk Candy Store to discuss his store's unexpected growth during the pandemic, the business problems that growth has exposed, and how his current e-commerce platform is holding him back. We've been tasked with going through his entire e-commerce operation and looking for opportunities to free up time via automation and to add new features to continue that growth. In this episode, we're going to explore the needs of the business, identify the right e-commerce platform, and build the site that will be the foundation of everything we're going to do to improve Bulk Candy Store's business. This is the e-commerce makeover. Bulk Candy Store's growing, but they're still a small business. Their e-commerce being built on an open source platform is consuming all of their resources. And that means the things they need to be focused on to continue that growth are not getting the proper attention. Just fixing this will have a big impact, but it's not the only consideration. Let's learn more from Ken about what he's looking for from his next e-commerce platform. What are you looking for in an e-commerce platform?
I'm looking for a couple of things in an e-commerce platform. I want something that'll grow with us.
Sure.
And that's easier to use, and that I don't have to spend time developing. With Magento One, I had to have a developer in-house. I didn't want a developer who's in here full-time when I could get the same software someplace else, hopefully, have plugins do it and use the money for something else like inventory or marketing.
So are there any customizations on your current site that we need to make sure get moved over to the new one?
Most of our customizations are around, hey, we want to tell you as much as we can now so you know the product, you know what you're getting, you know when you're getting it, and you don't have to bother calling me to find that information out. As an example, we have a lot of kosher food, we have a big audience for it, and we need to be able to tag every item with its kosher symbol if it's kosher.
That makes sense.
Another is regarding shipping. Because we ship a lot of chocolate, we need to have a way to notify customers, hey, we're shipping chocolate, and if you don't do it this way in particular, your chocolate may melt and we can't be responsible.
So are there any integrations with the site currently that also need to transfer over to the new site?
Well, I'll tell you what we're using and you can help figure that out. We're using MailChimp for our email, we're using Yotpo for reviews, we're using Clevu for search, and we're using Shipworks for our shipping.
Are you satisfied with those solutions, or are we trying to reevaluate everything?
They work, so we're satisfied with them, but if there are ways to use them better, or there's something else that comes along that gives us more functionality, I'm very happy to look at other software.
Is there anything that you're not able to do currently that we need to make sure we address with the new platform?
I'd like the customers to see when the order is going to get there. I want to cut down on the number of support calls I get going, my order shipped, when's it going to be there?
Okay.
I also want to do much better shipping estimates. I'd also like to be able to do things like subscription services, maybe some loyalty. So there are a bunch of things that we'd like to do. We want to change our shipping procedure because we'd like to ship faster. We're spending a little too much time sometimes shipping orders and getting them ready. We want to be able to cut down the cost of shipping for our customers. In certain cases, because some of our popcorn, for example, is big and light, the carriers charge a lot of extra fees for it, and we don't have the ability to calculate what that number really will be, and we wind up actually overcharging the customers for shipping. A lot of these things are things that we talked about earlier, but we couldn't get done because we knew Magento is coming to the end of its life, and it's going to require programming, and then it's going to have to change again, and I don't want to have to go through that again.
Does that mean we shouldn't be considering another open source platform?
I don't have an IT department, and I don't want to spend time developing things. I want something that's pre-built and ready to go.
Is there anything else that we need to be aware of, we need to make sure we're addressing with the new site build?
When we build a new site, one of the things that I'd like to look at is things like conversion rate. We have a terrible conversion rate. We'd like to be able to do recurring sales. That's a big one for us. We'd like to be able to do a little more on-site marketing. We want to be able to use pop-ups and use our email a little more effectively. And I'd like to be able to look at the data a little more cleanly. One of the things that I wasn't able to get as often as I'd like were reports for some of the plugins or software that we use so we could go ahead and actually make adjustments.
Our goal with this project is to make things easier for Bulk Candy Store to manage. By doing so, we'll free up a lot of time and money to invest in other tools and strategies to continue their growth. After my conversations with Ken, I'm recommending BigCommerce. I think it's the right fit for this project because of its focus on flexibility. We're going to get that lower technical overhead that Ken desires, but on a platform that is an easy transition from the open source flexibility he's accustomed to. Before we get into the BigCommerce migration, if you want more details on how we're helping Bulk Candy Store, go to ecommercemakeover.com for our playbook on everything we're doing, including special offers on all the tools we'll be using. And of course, subscribe as we document the entire process in this series. Now let's go straight to the source to learn more about BigCommerce and how their platform's design and focus will solve a lot of bulk candy stores' issues.
Hi, I'm Brent Bellum, CEO of BigCommerce, headquartered here in Austin, Texas. We are a software platform that helps businesses of all shapes and sizes around the world create beautiful, high-performing online stores. Open source software was the most popular option 5-10 years ago because it gives so much flexibility and control to businesses. But now what we have is called Open SaaS. And with SaaS, you get similar advanced enterprise flexibility and scalability, but the openness of it via APIs and software developer kits means that you can modify it and adjust it to your needs and heart's content without having the burden of owning, managing your own software.
Although I think it's a great fit, this is not my decision to make. Let's let Ken sit down with BigCommerce and make sure he's comfortable with this decision before we move forward.
Hi, Ken. It's a pleasure to connect. How are you?
I'm great, thanks.
As a quick introduction, my name is Ryan Fees. My job is to facilitate the evaluation process. To kick us off, what does e-commerce look like for you today, and where are you guys trying to go?
We've been online since 98. Went to Magento because I thought it had a little more capabilities, and then found out as I went along it got more and more complex. I wound up having to have a full-time developer. I also don't want to have someone who controls so much of my life as a developer did.
And where are you guys trying to go?
The thing that I wanted the most is ease of use. As far as moving forward, I like some of the multi-channel integrations. We'd like to do more things to reach our customers. So for example, we'd like to do loyalty programs. We'd like to be able to do subscription programs, things that we held off on. And then we found out they were more difficult to do with Magento, where it required plugins and programming and things, and it became a little bit more of a nightmare than it should.
BigCommerce can obviously be a great fit there. We have all the integrations off the shelf that's necessary to be able to integrate. All of those that you touched on are something that, you know, BigCommerce can help facilitate.
Choosing a popular e-commerce platform with a vibrant ecosystem is essential. The reason is that e-commerce is very complex. There are so many different choices in terms of whom you might use for payments, shipping, fulfillment, email marketing, accounting or ERP, or various little apps and extensions for your website design and customer experience. A big ecosystem gives you choice across lots of different providers to pick the ones that work best for your business.
In terms of total cost of ownership with your current platform, can you kind of walk me through what that looks like?
I'm talking $5,000-$6,000 a month between developer and hosting and everything else. I'm hoping BigCommerce will bring a big change to that.
The historical model of open source software was very expensive in the total cost of maintaining, hosting, bug fixing, securing their software. In contrast, a typical mid-market customer using BigCommerce's SaaS will be paying less of their online sales in our service, which comes with all of that built in. That extra amount of financial resources can then be channeled into marketing and customer service, growing your business. I think just as importantly, the mind share. So when you own and are responsible for all of your own software, the attention span, the panic you're in constantly about keeping your site up, keeping it safe and secure, it's overwhelming. And that really takes down companies from where they should be spending their time and attention on their website, which is in design, in customer experience, and in enhancements that bring in and convert more customers.
We have a lot of tools that we want to spend money on that'll provide big returns. So we need to be smart with this implementation and keep the budget in check as much as we can. To save on development costs, we decided to use a pre-existing theme and then customize it using the fun and colorful tone that Ken wanted. This saved dozens of hours of developer time that can be invested in other areas. We also set up a few key apps and integrations that we'll talk about in more detail in the upcoming episodes. From there, it just needed data. We migrated the customer accounts, products, and orders from their Magento site, and the store was ready to launch. Bulk Candy Store's new BigCommerce site has been online for a few weeks. When we get to the end of the series, we're going to look at the long-term results. For now, let's check in with Ken and see how it's going so far.
Early results.
How have they been?
So far, the orders have been coming in smoothly. We've had really very little problem. There's been a very short learning curve. So I think that that's been great. We had a slight dip in our organic web traffic, and that hurt. I think that was sort of expected.
Definitely.
We're slowly building back to where we were and actually surpassing it. I think just today we did about triple what we did yesterday. So that's a nice number to look at. So it's really been building up. So I'm real happy with it.
Conversion rates seem to be higher. Like everything seems to be moving along pretty well.
Conversion rates are actually much higher. We were in the 0.6, 0.9 range before. Conversion rates on most days are almost 2%, 1.6, 1.8, 2%. So which is almost double what we were getting before. So we're real happy with that. If I can keep that up in that higher range, I'm going to be your best friend.
So you're going to be sending me a subscription service if yes. We can keep that one.
I'm going to be sending you lots of candy. Lots of, you keep me in the twos, lots of candy coming at you.
So how's the process been migrating to BigCommerce?
Your team has been great to work with. They're very communicative. They ask questions. They make sure I understand everything. That's really good. And the partners have been wonderful as well. They give us all the training and support we need to get things up and running. So far I'd say the transition is great. We're just getting started. We're just building things in, but so far everything is just way better and easier than it was before.
Now you've only been on BigCommerce for a very short time.
Right.
But what are you most excited about?
What we're excited about really most is just the opportunity to grow. There's some plugins that we put in and we're just starting with that we think will really help our business. Plus, I think BigCommerce is very supportive. The fact that I can call support in the middle of the night and ask a question when I'm doing something and I get an answer is just great for me. Besides the support, one of the things I really like about BigCommerce is they're very, very proactive with their customers. So they have a discussion forum where you can go in and you can post requests for updates and they actually read it, listen to it. And then once a month they have a town hall where they tell you everything that's come out, everything that's changed. And they even highlight websites that are new. And one of the things I really like is that they make a point of saying, look, we added these features and we added it because our customers asked and they show you in the forums. I think they're very, very customer centric. They really want to help you grow. So I'm real happy with that.
We now have that solid foundation to start building up Bulk Candy Store's business. You can click here to watch the next video in this series where we improve their conversion rates by fixing their shipping calculations. Be sure to click and download our playbook on how we're growing Bulk Candy Store and to receive special offers on the tools that we'll be using. And of course, subscribe to be notified when we release new episodes.